find it really interesting that your journey after about 7.5 years in the military, you left briefly for about a year, and you decided to rejoin the military. What actually happened? What brought you back?
So, I'll tell you what drove me out, and I'll tell you what brought me back. Actually, and it's happened twice now, now that I think about it. But at the 7.5 year point, you know, the wing commander brings you in and says, hey, the two of you, are gonna be two below to major, which means you're gonna be advanced promoted a couple years ahead to major. And both of us looked at each other, and he was gonna go to the airline, and I was gonna go fly float planes, and we both said, sir, we're gonna bail on ya, right? And he says, traitors. And I'm like, wow, powerful word, right? Well, this was 1989, and the airlines were really hiring, so there was a flood of pilots going out and flying for the airlines. I never wanted to do that, and all my friends do that, and I thought, that's not me. I wanted to fly float planes, so I did that. And then did that for about 6 months and got my first couple paychecks, and I'm like, what, $17,000 a year? Who lives on this, right, kind of thing. And I thought, I better make an adjustment here. And so I came back in. And I came back in full time because I missed it. So I've been in the reserve, Air Force Reserve, for actually 28 years. And I'm the first reservist to ever reach the rank of four-star. But I spent 28 years in the Air Force Reserve. But all of it was full time except for two. A period of time when I owned a restaurant. So,
I find that interesting. Going back, when you come back into the Air Force, you actually are flying and you're actually working, running a restaurant, basically almost at the same time when you're not in the military. How are you doing both at the same time, and how do you balance your life work? At that time,
it was hard. You know, you really get a sense of what a reservist goes through, because, like I said, in the Air Force Reserve, I was full time, so that's all I did. You couldn't tell me from an active duty member. You could not tell me, because same jobs, same moving all the time, same everything. But when I owned the restaurant for 5 years, I thought, if my business partner and I are going to jump into this endeavor, we're going to get everything we have. And so I walked away from the Air Force Reserve. So I did it part time. And couldn't keep up. You know, the squadron would call, are you going to come and fly and get current this month? No, I'm not. Put me on the schedule next month. And I went non-current, and I went unqualified. It's hard to own a business and try to stay current in a weapon system at the same time. It's really, really difficult. Then September 11th happened. So my retirement paperwork was in. My wing commander passed me in the hallway one day, and he goes, where are you going? I got my retirement paperwork in. I'm going to go file it. And he goes, oh, why don't you just give it to me? I'll hang on to this, right? He sticks it in the bottom drawer. And he goes, I don't think you're going to retire. I said, you need to follow this. Oh, I got it. Stick it in the bottom drawer. 2 months later, September 11th happened. And I called him up and I said, hey, do not file that paperwork. He goes, nope, I ripped it up. You know, and so basically, I asked to come back full time. And I said, I want to come back full time. My business partner said, do it, right? In fact, that day, that Tuesday morning, when you all know, right, when that Tuesday morning happened, I called the squadron and said, do I need to come? And they said, stay put. We don't know what's going to happen yet. You know, we'll call you. I can be there in 2 hours. I live in Rehoboth Beach. I can be to D.C. in 2 hours. They called my business partner right away. She's an operating room nurse. They said, get to Andrews now. 30 minutes later, she's on the road to Andrews. So I'm standing there going, wow, what's going to happen? What has just happened? Right, what has just happened? So by that Friday, I thought, D.C. is just going to hunker down and nobody's going to leave. The opposite happened. Everyone just flooded to the beach. Everybody thought, I got to get out of here. We were just busy like you couldn't believe. And that Friday night, restaurant was packed. They had a 110-seat restaurant. It was packed. And a friend of mine comes up and he says, hey, you need to go talk to that table over there. And I'm like, Sam, I don't know, I have time to talk to that table. And he goes, get over there and talk to that man. So I walk over there. This man stands up, turns around, gives me a hug, and he starts crying. And he says, you're a pilot? And I go, yeah. He says, you're in the Air Force Reserve? I said, yeah. He goes, my brother was a co-pilot of Flight 93. Yeah. And I'm like, you got to be kidding me. So we said, outside, let's go outside. So I had a secret garden in the back. And in the secret garden, there were tables. And under the arborvitaes and the crepe myrtles, and it was just beautiful. And we would rarely take anybody back there. And I said, back to the garden. Mm-hmm. So we went back to the secret garden, and we stayed there all night. Mm-hmm. And he says, what happened? How, you know, help me explain. Help me understand what happened. I said, we won't know. We won't know for a while what happened. Mm-hmm. But that was just absolutely amazing.
So he gave more meaning to you.
Yeah, and he was a reservist. Mm-hmm. So it was just incredible. So then I came back full time and sold the restaurant the next year. It's hard to be deployed and mobilized. I was actually mobilized at that point.
Where is Rehoboth Beach?
So Rehoboth Beach, near Ocean City, 20 miles north of Ocean City.
Where is that, in Maryland or Virginia?
Delaware. It's
okay.
In Delaware.
Okay.
The Delaware Shore.
The Delaware Shore, not the Jersey Shore.